India's vision for 2020 is to emerge as Asia's next superpower, and the nation's critical sectors are driving this success story. One of these sectors is education, and one of India's most aspired qualifications is a management degree. With a vision to set new standards for India's B-schools, Manish Jain incepted Indus Business Academy at Bengaluru in 2001, giving up a successful career to revolutionize India's education sector.
We always used to feel that, you know, there is something which is missing in students, and hiring is a problem. You are not able to get what you want, so you have to spend a lot of money in training them. That's how this whole idea cropped up, that we should have an institute which focuses more on life skills and practical skills rather than, you know, getting too much into what is there in the book.
Indus Business Academy offers management programs for both fresh graduates as well as experienced professionals. But providing just education is not the core agenda of this specialist business institute. This visionary school instills core market values in students, preparing them for stiff competition and long corporate battles. Indus Business Academy's residential campus in Bengaluru hosts around 200 students, boasting of being a campus that never sleeps. In 2006, it established its second campus in the National Capital Region at Greater Noida, and the best practices from its pioneering institute are followed here as well. Regular student and faculty exchange programs knit these two IBA campuses into a single family. This leading management institute hopes innovation will become an integral part of India's education by 2020 and aims to produce future-ready market leaders who will script the nation's success story.
Anything which is given free, they do not do well. Education, free education, students don't come. But I believe that if you have corporates coming saying that, okay, I'll give you free education, parents actually feel more secured. You know, corporates getting into education, and it's survival of the fittest. So 2020, we will see a lot of, you know, institutes which are there today, they might vanish, and fairly good amount of institutes will come up who will have the niche and who will have the competence to survive.
Indus Business Academy is emerging as one of the reputed management institutions thanks to its strong focus on quality. It is among India's 27 institutions to receive an international accreditation from IACBE. Sowing the seeds of growth with two campuses in India, IBA plans to establish its international presence by 2020, a dream that will boost India's prowess in the education sector.
All right. I hope you can hear me. If you can you please raise your hand and signal that you can hear me? Thank you. Can you now unraise your hands so that I don't see so many hands in class? Of course, as a class, this looks very interesting that so many persons have raised their hands. Okay, can you put down your hands again? Thank you. My name is Chandrakant, and some of you are already connected to me on LinkedIn and Facebook. As I said in my introduction, I have been with IBA since 2001 from the first batch. Many of these first batch alumnus are pretty old and have children who I also help, who I also hope will join IBA. my career has been in technology, and I have worked with all the big investment banks across the world. And because of this knowledge of technology, I also help IBA in terms of its technology. And today's discussion is about how do we use technology in order to teach and learn. So many of you know how to learn using technology because Google is obviously your favorite teacher. So we are not replacing Google. Google is great, but Google gives you data. Google can give you opinions. But what we want to teach you is to go beyond it, understand whether opinions are right, wrong, counter argue, and form your own opinions about life. Great. There are a lot of technologies that we use. The first technology that we are using is obviously Zoom. And you have seen a Zoom webinar in the morning. You will gradually be getting into Zoom meetings. The difference between a webinar and a meeting is that in a webinar, there are some people who are speaking and the rest of the guys are listening, almost like a class. You can raise a hand, you can possibly have a chat if the panelist or if the teacher allows you to, but the teacher cannot see you and you cannot see each other. In a meeting, you can all see each other. You can probably mute your video, you can probably mute your audio, but we can request you to show your audio and your video, okay, and we can have a conversation. While the rains are happening, there will be communication issues. There will be communication issues at your side because of the clouds there and the rain. There will be communication issues from our side because of the clouds and the rain. But as we have been teaching your senior batch and your super senior batch using the online media also, we have become quite experienced and we are used to various problems that happen. And most of these problems in the initial stage are there, but subsequently they all settle down and we are able to become productive. So take it with a pinch of salt. Across 1 week, we will all settle down and things will be fine. Now, coming to technology and tools. Evidently, MS Office is a very important tool. And Word, Excel, PowerPoint, and Outlook are your weapons in terms of communication. I'm sure that all of you know what Word, Excel, and PowerPoint are, but now we are coming to a postgraduate level. Now, frontier between you and the companies. When you are an employee of the company, you have to show things a lot more professionally. And we teach you how to be professional. We teach you not to make even a single mistake so that whenever you present, whenever you write, whenever you do calculations, you are perfect because perfection is where the salaries are. Apart from that, we use many other tools. One of them is XMind, which we use in order to do mind mapping. Let me see if I can show you an XMind screen. Before that, let me show you a PowerPoint screen so that you have a certain idea as to how we use graphics and things like that. So I am now going to share with you a PowerPoint screen. Okay, and Kalakshetra is actually a field project. It is an assignment that students have to do in groups. And last year, the assignment was to grow vegetables and sell them to the alumni. So you learned how farmers work. You learn how dependent we are on rain. And you also learn how to connect the alumni and sell to them while competing with each other. Now, this is a slide, and you can see that I have a very dark background. The reason between dark and light backgrounds is something that we are going to tell you subsequently. When do we use what? I'm going to move forward on this slide just to show you how things are done. So you can see that there is a heading on top always. There is in yellow the main items, and then there are bullet points. You can see that we have a lot of graphics. You can see that in this case, year on year, since 2011, we have been doing Kalakshetra. And you can see how the graphics is changing. Okay, while the main aspect of it, the goals, etc., remain the same. All these things you will have to do, and you have to talk about it so that you can actually present. To give you an example of XMind, this is a this is something that I have taught, and I have used this as a basis for an entire seminar. The course is Financial Markets and Instruments, and it's broken up into four headings. Who are the players? What are the needs? And what are the instruments? And where are the markets? And you can actually open each one of them in a hierarchical fashion. You can open this in a hierarchical fashion and so on, so that you can get a tree on tree on tree. And you can hide each one of them so that the users are not very confused, and use this as a basis for presentations. So this is called mind mapping, and I shall be teaching you more about mind mapping as a tool for creative writing, which will not be today. Now I'll come to the most important part of today's presentation, which is using Moodle, which is our learning management system. So I'm going to now share a screen with you. All right. I am hoping that you can see what I have shown out here. Please note the URL out here. This URL, I believe, has been sent to you. And this URL basically links to the IBA learning management system. Now, whether you access this on the mobile phone or whether you access it through your laptop is immaterial. The screens are practically the same. Now, I have already created user IDs for you, and you will be getting a message if you have already not got a message as to what is your user ID and what is your initial password. As soon as you log in, you will have to change your password. Okay, so here, this is a fake ID, which is a student ID, and I'm using this to show you what you will see. As a teacher, I see different things. As a student, you see different things. So as soon as you type in your user ID and your password and click login, and by the way, here is something called forgotten your user ID and password. So typically we do forget. And if your email is good, then using this particular link, you can actually change your password or remember your user ID. You will get a link on your and on an email, and clicking that will allow you to change the password. So as soon as I log in, I will see this screen. Now watch this screen very carefully. I'm just trying to figure out where are the zooms. All right. Now, if you watch the screen very carefully, there are two or three things that are important. First and foremost, all your messaging is out here. So as you can see that I have received a message, and if I click on it, I can see what are the messages that I have got. For example, I have got a message from PGP office, which is the office that you will be connecting to for all academic related activities. Okay, so PGP office is where you talk about attendance, where you talk about course outlines, where you talk about submissions, scheduling, etc., etc. This is the single point of contact. You can see that Professor Chandrakant has sent two emails. Okay. and the other two emails that have been given. Okay, and these are all test messages. Now, you can, for example, search for a teacher. For example, if I want to search for Suresh Chandra sir, I can type Suresh and say click. Okay, and I can see that here. And I can send him a message, okay, saying, and I can send the message to him. And Suresh sir will receive the message and he will reply to you. All right. The second thing is the notifications panel, where you will get notifications which are pertinent to the system. It is not very important. You should upload your photographs so that we can recognize you. And if you click on this, you can see dashboard. You can see your profile. You can see your grades. You can see your messages. And you can change a few things around. Let's look at profile. This is a typical profile that you will also see, where you will see your email address, you will see your country, and you will also see who is your mentor. Furthermore, it will also tell you which courses are you logged into or which courses you are registered for, so that you can go to each course. Beyond that, you can look at your forums and so on, and you can also modify your profile for certain things. You can change your email address. Okay, you can probably put in your city or town. Okay, and this, but you can look at who your mentors are. So that is for updating your profile. Very important in this case, please do update your profile with your selfie. Hopefully a decent selfie, not with pouts or anything like that. All right. So that was the profile. Now, most important place is this home. And this is what you see when you log in. You can see that there are certain site announcements which are out here. And these are very important for you to look at. You can see the list of all the courses which are there out here. And it can be a very big list. And if you see, it is broken up in terms of the courses that are my courses, the one that I am subscribed to, and the other courses which are available where the teacher is going to subscribe you if it is of 2020 your batch courses, and there are also a lot of 2019 courses and so on and so forth. If you go to the left-hand side, you see the navigation. Now, evidently, my courses are all here. These are the courses that I am subscribed to. You can see that under 2020, you have the orientation program. Under orientation program, this student is subscribed to 3 courses. This course is one of the most important courses, and you should be visiting this often, because in this course, you can see all the announcements. For example, there is the announcement out here which says that today there is a webinar on Moodle skills. If you click on it, you can see the information about this thing. So all your scheduling, all your classes, all information is going to be put in this announcement. And if you are not going there often enough, you might be missing some of the announcements. All right. I have sent a test message to all of you, and at some juncture you will receive it and you will have to log in into Moodle in order to reply to it. Going back again, we are still navigating. This is basically the list of all the courses, and if you click on it, you will find the following. In 2019, there is a trimester 4 courses, the other trimester 5 courses. This is what is going on right now. In the PGDM, we have got the orientation, and all these courses are there in the orientation. Some of them are, like, for example, the accounting courses are based on sections, and you might have access to some of them and you might not have access to the others. in the skill and personality development, which I sort of control, for example, right now, there are all the placement related tests, all the interview questions are there, which we keep updating, all the aptitude tests are there so that you can practice for placement and so on. So over time, you will get access to it. So let's go to one particular course that you are subscribed to. I'm just going to check whether there are any messages or anything like that. Yeah, there can't be any messages, so that's fine. If you need to connect with me, you can always go to Moodle, search for me. For example, you can go out here, you can go to messages. Okay, you can search for Chandra, and you will find two Chandras here. One is Suresh Chandra sir and one is me. You can click on me and then you can send me a message and I shall receive it. All right. Okay. So back to home. The second most important thing that you will go to is something called the dashboard. Now, the dashboard is something that you can modify. So you can customize this page and you can add more things to it so that it becomes more accessible. So right now you can see what are the courses that I have accessed. You can see the list of all the courses out here. And very important, you see all the schedules out here. You can see who are the people who are logged in. You can see your calendar and the highlights are where. There are some events for me. If I click on this, it shows that some sample quiz will open. If I click on this, it shows that there are a lot of tests that you guys are going to do on the 17th. And on 22nd, there is another assignment that is due. And you can see all the events out here. You can click on a particular event. And details of that event will come. When does it start? When does it end? What are the comments? And you can actually go to the activity and do that particular assignment. So everything that a teacher of various courses is asking you to do, they will all be here. All right, now you can customize it. You can change it around and say, which one do I want to see where? You can add a few more panels to it. For example, you can see out here. And you can add some blocks. For example, if you want to add blocks about your learning plans, about the latest badges, and so on and so forth, you can add them if you want. So you customize it as you wish. You can move things. The calendar can be moved from here to the center so that you can see the entire calendar and so on. All right, so back to home again. Whenever you are subscribed to a particular course, and I'm going to take you to a particular course, this is a course called Learning at IBA. Okay. There are four teachers in this course. Let me show you at a different place how it looks. Now, I want you guys to play with this modules, log in, change your password. It is going to ask you to change the password mandatorily. And after that, go and surf the entire site to figure out your own navigation. It is very important that you make yourself familiar. Placement tests will be done through Moodle, and you should be fairly conversant as to how to use. Today, I'm going to show you how to do a particular quiz, so that you is done. If I go to the orientation program, you will see the name of the course, you will see the name of the teacher, and you will have a certain description in terms of what it is. Whichever courses you are subscribed to will be seen in My Courses, but here you are seeing an entire list of courses, even the ones that you are not subscribed to. You can, of course, search for courses if you want to. So as you can see, there are a lot of courses that you'll be doing. I shall be running some workshops with you, like a team building workshop. We have a workshop called Learning at IBA, where we teach you study, role play, field products, field projects, etc. I shall also be taking a course on critical thinking and problem solving, how not to be emotional while making decisions. That's a very important part. Suresh sir will be teaching you a lot of quant. And this is the most important one, the orientation program, where all the teachers are there and all information about the orientation program will be put out here. All right. So let's go to learning at IBA. As soon as you go to a particular course, look at the left-hand side, and the left-hand side menu options will change. Whatever is out here, case study, role play, field products, projects, simulation, group exercises, 3D, they are all there. So I have put in something called sample Moodle activities, and this is where you should go and practice and look at each one of them. For example, and this is the most important one, there is something called a sample quiz. So as soon as I click on sample quiz, information about this will come, that this is a sample quiz. It can be attempted once. Number of attempts allowed. Now this is very, very important. You can see that the quiz opened on 1:30 and the quiz will close 2 days later at 12:40 in the morning. But the time limit is 10 minutes. So you can log in and start the quiz whenever you want between these two times. But before the end time or before 10 minutes or after 10 minutes, the quiz will automatically shut down. And whatever you have done till then will get submitted. So now I'm going to attempt the quiz right now. As soon as I attempt the quiz, it gives you another warning that you have a time limit of 10 minutes. Once you start, the timer will start countdown. You cannot pause it. Okay, and you have to finish before this timer expires. Now, if you get logged out, typically the timer will stop. But it is possible that the timer may not stop. And when you log in again, you might not have enough time. So be very careful and make sure that you have a decent connection. So I'm now starting the attempt. And you can see out here that there are 10 questions. You can see the timer going down. And you have the first question out here. So this is a sort of sequence, and you have to calculate what is the sequence, and you have to click on the right one. You can clear it, you can redo it, but once you have gone to the next page, this is submitted. As you can see, it has already been submitted. Now you can't go back there and you have to move forward. Now this is a vocabulary question, and this is a sort of match and mix. So Outre is out here and you have to figure out which of them is the right answer and so on. Okay, and once you have filled this up, you can again go to the next page. Once you have finished all of them, or if the 10 minutes are over, you can always click on finish attempts, or you can go to the last one and save it. So this is just a sample quiz, and you guys can also run this quiz yourself in order to figure out how exactly quizzes happen. Now bear in mind that most of you will be using your mobile phone. This quiz will not look identical to this. It will be slightly different from that. Okay. And you can see the timer counting down. And once you have finished it, you can always click on finish. And it has been saved. Now, obviously, at this point, you can see that you have not answered many things. So therefore, you can say, oh my God, I might have clicked it by mistake. So I can go back to the attempt and continue working from there. So I'm at question number 8. I can select something. Then I can go to question number 9. I'm now going to the last question, selecting something, and I'm finishing the attempt. So this has all been done. Okay, and I can submit. And it is, my quiz is over. So this is a multiple choice quiz. In this multiple choice, you can actually see your answers and it will tell you which one is the correct answer, which one is the wrong answer. You can see what your marks are. Okay, and based on that, it also tells you what the right answers are so that you learn from it. This one is a particular vocabulary test, and typically in this vocabulary test, we allow you to have multiple attempts so that every time you are doing it, you are sort of learning additional vocabulary. All right, so you now know how many marks you have got. In fact, okay, this, as you can see, is called breadcrumbs, which allows you to navigate at the top. Here you can see your grades. Okay, you can see yourself out here, and in the grades, you can actually go and see how much marks you have got. As you can see in the sample quiz, I have got 1.1 out of 10 marks. All right. Again, going back to this, the other type of things that you will have is quiz is multiple choice, etc. You can also have an assignment. In the case of an assignment, okay, it is offline. You are actually going to tell the assignment and you are going to write it and then you are going to submit it. In this case, this is the question. It is an assignment. Tell me about yourself in 140 characters and upload your CV. So here I can say, I am a teacher or something like that. I am, and you can see that it is an HTML type, so you can highlight, bold, I can select this and I can bold it. Okay. And if I click out here, I can see even more information. I can put in a table, I can put in a calendar, I can write justify, I can indent, I can center justify, superscript, subscript. Everything that you can do on Word is possible to do out here. Here it has also been allowed that you can take a particular file and you can upload a file and you can add it out here. So because the question had said, please upload your CV, so it might be a good idea to put your CV out here so that your mentor might be able to see. And after that, you can save the changes. So the difference between a quiz is that quiz is online. It can be MCQ, it can be essay type, all types of questions can come and it will be graded. An assignment is something that is sort of offline. You can submit. Okay, and you can put in that information out there. Okay, you can edit this or you can delete it and you can rewrite it until the due date is over. The third type of Moodle activity that a teacher can do is a lesson. In a lesson, there might be a theory. It is like a chapter of a book where you might have some theory and you might have some tests in the middle of it. And there, now this is, for example, a theory. Okay, here we have written something about how does a student learn, blah, 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 etc., etc. All right. The other type of activity that you will see on Moodle, which a teacher might put, is, for example, a URL. So a URL might be a link to a YouTube video, it might be a link to some data, etc. And you might click on that and you can actually go and see that particular link. Another type of activity which will be there in your course is a chat. So a teacher might enable a chat And this is, for example, a chat out here. And we can use this chat in order to write things, and other people who have joined the chat can also communicate. So sometimes a teacher might use the chat forum in order to converse with you. Okay. And you can write things and your problems. And then other people who are there might respond to it. So chats will also be there, which will be used by the teacher in order to have some communication with you, or to explain a particular assignment, and so on and so forth. All right, in general, this is what will happen. What you are going to see is topics. Within the topics, there might be subtopics and lessons. Okay, there might be assignments and other activities, and this is the sum total of your course, one particular subject. In that particular subject, you will also see your grades, and overall, when you look at yourself, you can see your overall grades across all your subjects. So you can go here as a participant, you can go to yourself as an IBS student, that is what I am. Okay, you can go out here and you can see your grades overview. In a grades overview, you can see all your courses and what grades have you received in that particular course. So on a real-time basis, as the teachers are running their courses and they are grading these assignments, you will keep on knowing what is your status in that particular course. You will also know your ranking. Compared to other persons, how well have you done in terms of ranking? So if you were the best answers and you got the best grade, then you will be one out of 180 or 190 students which are there. But if it was the worst, then you will see yourself as 190 by 190, and therefore you know that you have to do something better over time. So as you can see, we can go back and forth all over the place. I can see my grade report. I can see a breakup of each one of them in that particular course. How much have I got in each one of them? So that was one particular course that I am teaching, and I've used this as an example. Now it is very important for you to log in and check this out in terms of what are the various types of courses. You can also run by yourself each one of them. Day after tomorrow, even maybe tomorrow, you will be subjected to a lot of pre-assessment so that we can understand how good are you in accounting, how good you are in communication, how good are you in computers, and how good are you in business mathematics. Based on that, we are going to start doing some remedial exercises with you so that you are at par with all these others. So it is possible that tomorrow I'll be setting up an online chat with you so that you can log in and talk to me in terms of what you found useful, where you found problems, what did you not understand, so that we can go through it again. Now, this particular video we are recording. So therefore, we will make this video also available to you so that you can go through that. And in case you have any problems, you can figure out what has to be done. Again, going back to this, the most important course right now is this orientation program. This is where you are going to see all your announcements and so on and so forth. All right. Okay. Thanks a lot. And that takes care of my particular session. I see that there are some hands that have been raised, but unfortunately, this webinar is set in such a way that we cannot really communicate with each other. Okay, so therefore, the only way right now to communicate with me, very frankly, is for you to log in to Moodle and then send me a message. Okay, I'm generally available, so I should be able to respond to you quick enough. That's about it. So what we have done in order to summarize, and I have gone through it fairly quickly, primarily because of a lack of time and primarily because many of these things cannot really be taught by giving a demonstration. It is more by you using it. So go ahead, log in, move around, see what are there. There are a lot of tests out there for it that are available for you. Go and do them. All right. So that's about it. Thanks a lot, folks, and best of luck in IBA. You can all leave now because I have finished with my presentation. Thank you.